Salutations, celestial sightseers. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The autumn sky. On September 22nd, the Earth reached its equinox, the autumn one for those of us in the northern hemisphere. That means cooler days and more bundling up for observing during the, wait for it, woohoo! That's right, longer nights. Okay, so maybe only us amateur astronomers get excited over things like that. So what can we see in the autumn sky? Well, let's take a look. 3 hours after sundown in the early autumn, many of the prominent summer constellations appear to be leaving us. Arcturus of Boötes is on the horizon. Up and to his left, the dimmer stars of Hercules are not far behind. And across the southwestern horizon, Ophiuchus and Sagittarius are hugging the tree line. Interestingly, though, the stars just above them, the first magnitude ones that form the summer triangle, Deneb, Vega, and Altair here, will stick around in the evening sky thanks to darkness arriving earlier in the evening. Of course, these three bright stars anchor the constellations of Cygnus, Lyra, and Aquila, which we have talked about over the course of the summer itself. So what does that leave us with? Well, to the south, there's just a single bright star now, Fomalo, the brightest star in Pisces Austrinus, the southern fish, an otherwise very dim constellation. But we can use it to help us find the second magnitude stars of Capricornus the Sea Goat, up into its right, near to where Neptune is located now. If we go from Fomalo towards up overhead, in darker skies, we'd pass by Aquarius the Water Bearer, though most of us in light polluted areas will just see blank sky here until we reach the second magnitude stars of the Great Square of Pegasus, even though Uranus is presently near Aquarius and visible with binoculars. But what is useful for stargazers about the Great Square is that each of these stars is about 15 degrees from each other, which is a helpful dimension to find some of the other autumn constellations. At the southwesternmost star, we can hop about 15 degrees, then angle half again as far to the nose of Pegasus the Winged Horse at 2.4 magnitude Enif. Off the adjacent star on the square are the legs of Pegasus. Moving to the opposite side is second magnitude Alpheratz, which is actually of Andromeda, the Chained Princess. And two more, 15 degree hops from there, takes us to two more of her second magnitude stars, Myrac and Almac. And with one last 15 degrees jump from there, we arrive at Princess Andromeda's beau, the hero Perseus, by locating his brightest star, also second magnitude, Mirfak. Rising in the east, a similar distance away, is one of the brightest stars in the northern hemisphere, 42 light-years distant Capella of Auriga, the charioteer. Turning to the north, one would be remiss to overlook Andromeda's parents, the W, or at this time of year, M-shaped Queen Cassiopeia, and the upside-down house-shaped, and slightly dimmer, Cepheus the King, each of which sit above the Little Bear, Ursa Minor, and the North Star, Polaris. In autumn, the Milky Way runs approximately from Capella, through the royal couple, past Deneb in Cygnus, and on through Altair in Aquila. Later in the season towards the east, some stars more associated with winter are rising, with the distinctive shapes of Orion's Belt and its bright stars, plus Aldebaran of Taurus, where Jupiter will be located all autumn long. And now this week's dark sky fact. The city of Bristol in the United Kingdom recently turned off all of their streetlights and experienced a 50% reduction in crime. Since Mars and Saturn are so low in the sky after sunset, Jupiter is now the sole evening planetary highlight, rising high enough to be observed an hour or so before midnight. The moon is full on the 29th, and depending on the hour, slides just 4 or 5 degrees from Uranus, which was highlighted in last week's video. Neptune is still near Epsilon Aquarii, which is not too far a hop from second magnitude Deneb, Algedi, and Capricornus. And Venus lights the way for the sunrise as it makes a beeline from the Beehive Cluster towards Regulus in Leo the Lion this week. A donation to Eyes on the Sky helps keep these weekly videos ad-free on YouTube, and my sincere thanks to everyone who has donated to keep them that way. Of course, sharing these on social networking sites helps others learn about the night sky and light pollution reduction efforts. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down by using dark sky-friendly lighting fixtures so we can all see what's up.